Team Chaka Belize, welcome to your annual appreciation celebration for the 2015-2016 fiscal year. It has been an interesting year for us at Chaka Belize as we adjust to the ever-changing dynamic world of tourism, and in particular, that of the cruise sector. The 2015-2016 fiscal year saw 29 cruise calls, less than the previous year. But despite that downfall, we did an average guest per cruise call of 470 persons, only down by one from the previous year. Overall, for our last fiscal year, we provided tour services to 143,327 persons, and the year ended with 305 cruise calls to the Belize City Port. So where did these thousands of vacationers go? Well, the soft adventure tours at our Jaguar Paw Adventure Outpost accounted for 39% of them, or just over 56,460, enjoying cave tubing, crystal cave exploration, zip lining, and the newest edition of the jungle motorized tours of ATV and jungle buggies with all the various combinations. The airboat adventure post, which started it all about 14 years ago, remained strong and consistent with 11% of the total guests, or just over 17,000 guests. Our sightseeing bus tours continue to be a force to be reckoned with, accounting for almost half of the total guests at 49%, or just over 68,690 persons, enjoying the rich culture and diversity of Altunha and the Belize River, or as we affectionately call it, River Wallace, Sanantinich, Maya Temples, Cajal Pech, when we can't access Sanantinich, the Belize City Highlights, Lamanai, Maya Temples, Rum Tasting with Barafuna Cultural Entertainment, and the Old Belize Virtual Tour Museum with the Kukumba Beach Experience. Of course, no experience in Belize would be complete without a visit to the second largest coral reef in the world, and our small but fun, efficient, and safe snorkeling unit rounded off the balance of guests of just over 1,000 with our Barrier snorkeling tour primarily being offered to Caribbean Princess and Sea Cloud cruises. We, all of us with our teamwork, continue to dominate the cruise sector in Belize with having the majority of contracts with all the cruise lines. It is your effort and it is your support we continue to do this. While the cruise sector is our primary sector for tour services, we do have a small but efficient resort sales unit of two persons led by Melicia Banks and Karina Quinil. These two ladies have for this past fiscal year catered to hundreds of overnight visitors to Belize, as well as Belizeans looking for a day's adventure or a local company group event. This small unit has us promoted on the radio, social media, and BTEX, showcasing that we are a tour operator catering to all visitors coming to Belize, whether by air, sea, or land, and to Belizeans exploring home. The young, energetic, vibrant OPR team came together under the stewardship of Marlon, Andrea, Hilma, Aviana, and Derek at their location, demonstrating creativity, commitment, and team spirit. Yes, it has been a challenging year, but notwithstanding that, we all have played a role in remaining relevant and in sustaining the work we do. All of us, the office team, the guides whose services we contract for each tour day, the maintenance personnel and river rangers contracted to help in ensuring we are operating in a clean and organized environment, our safety officers who look out for our number one priority and assist when medical attention is required, our location management teams, and our senior management team. A big thank you. I saw us come together from Ms. Choco in time of need, showing grit, heart, and authentic and sincere compassion for our fellow colleague. I saw us welcome three more babies and celebrating motherhood. I saw your resilience as we brought back operations quickly after Hurricane Irma. At last year's appreciation event, we recognized 15 persons for their 10 years of service with the company. We acknowledged 20 merit awards as well. Also in the 2015-2016 year, we have a first staff retreat for the permanent administrative team where we held an informative yet fun learning team building exercise at the Jarbopa location. Team Wharton and a sincere interest to continually learn and improve in knowledge and in the delivery of customer service is what drives us each year to ensure we provide periodic training throughout the year. So we did no less and provided rescue training for the zipline system operators, ATV and jungle buggy training for the ATV buggy unit operators, standards operating procedures training for the cave tubing and Maya Temple tour guides, and customer service training for the OPR personnel. We also provided various members of the administrative staff with training in coaching and mentoring in computer awareness to prevent viruses, report writing, and GSD compliance. I know we may not always agree at times. I know there are good days and not so good days. But I sincerely believe that we have come a long way, each and every one of us, in understanding one another, working with one another, and doing our best for the company to improve constantly and how we do what we do. I am so proud to be working with you as your team lead and learning from you as well. I'm proud to be part of a team who respects each other, a team which practices responsible tourism, acknowledging the importance of showcasing our natural and cultural resources, but conserving them as well. A team who has fun in what they do, and a team who puts safety first in all that they do. It is fitting that we take time out to recognize the outstanding accomplishments of our peers and our teammates. Just as we provide the wow to our guests, we also acknowledge that you wow us every day too. So, let's have fun, relax, and enjoy today. It is your day, and we salute you.
Your water sink to release for the reasons of commitment, the fact that we have been consistent, and the fact that we have been innovative and creative. And what it says to all of us is that we're doing the right things. We're doing the right things and we're doing them right. You're doing things right every day, whether we are here or not. You are the example of what we like the operations to be. I went out into the field, and Diego can tell you, my response throughout, walking through JP, walking throughout the airport, is that you're doing things right. Down to the little details of how you finish the trails, how the trails look natural, the sign that you have, the way you're using materials instead of throwing them away and just trying to find new materials. Everything, the little details that you go into, it makes it is the DNA of what Chopper Brand is about. I do want to say that one of the reasons that I've been very focused on Jamaica is that in 2014 we had a blip. The blip came with a lot of what we consider to be our core individual tours. We saw where we were no longer growing. We found that some of the tours were starting to go into decline. And we had a real issue with it. In the midst of everything, what we started to do was really examine what was happening in the marketplace. And what we found happening in the marketplace was the millennial. The millennial, since 2015, is the largest buying group. The millennial had a very different buying behavior from what I had. And I had to stop looking and saying, I know what the customer wants. And we had to do some research, really look into it, and get an understanding of this, let's just say, new creature. And the changes have been dramatic. Being described as unfocused. They're into instant gratification. They have something called we grew up learning about a self image. They have a digital image. I'm saying this because one thing that 30 years in this business, Chaka has been in the business, does, is it teaches you, you don't have a right to any business. What you have a right to is understanding that we are in the business of experience. We have to remain relevant, and we have to take our collective experience more than ever before and apply it to the products that we do every day. And we need to have that eye out for the guest experience. What is it that puts a smile on the face? Because at the end of the day, that's our commitment in this business, right? Putting a smile on people's faces for what they paid, for how long they drove, and for what they get at the end of the day. That's what we do. Am I right?
Right.
Yeah, right.
That's in the end. People may say we're in the tour business. No. We are in the business of making people feel that this is the best vacation ever. And that because they've come to us, we have defined that vacation. Right? And when we start to separate ourselves from saying we're just in the tour, and start looking for what it is that is a highlight and how we can make those changes, we start to see that that little thing that we put into our core value, embracing change, is a critical part of who we are, who we need to be, right? We can't sit back at any point in time and think we can just continue doing things the same way and just doing it as good as we do. We have to look and say, how do we remain relevant, and at the same time, how do we differentiate ourselves from everybody else? Right? And if we can do those two things, relevant differentiation, we are going to continue to be ahead of the curve year after year. I wanted to say, although we're going to be giving this award, that the Carnival is right now looking for fewer, better tour operators. And they've identified that we have demonstrated both creativity in Belize, creativity, commitment, and consistency with our operations. So this is something that we proudly take. And you're welcome.
Tell me my leg, it was done.
every day. I've been here all day, on a rainy Saturday. All I need is you, right here, right now. Say my name.
Hi, my name is Karen Duban. I was born at Belize Old Hospital. I live on the George Price Highway between Hatteville and Gracie Rock Village. You can't miss it because it's right beside a bar named Stress Free. I have two beautiful girls. One is 7 and one is 1 year and 6 months old. Okay, I've been working with the company for over 10 years, going on 11 at this moment. What I like most about working with Chaka is you get to interact with different culture, see different people, learn new words, like Frizaho means bend the knees up, Maso means water, Tankishung means thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Rudy Romero, aka Rambo. I was born in Belmopan Hospital. I live the whole entire 25 years at Cotton Tree Village, which is located on mile 37 on the George Price Highway. I'm father of one son who is 4 years now. I've been working for the best since 2006, so I have 10 years and a couple months right now. What I love about my job is safety, working in heights, and also teamwork. Zipline has to do a lot of with teamwork, so that's what I love the most. And I also want to thank God for the, all the blessings that He has given me throughout my life, and also my supervisors and my managers. Thank you so much. Appreciate that. Whoop!
Go.
Yeah, man.
Everybody have a dream. Everybody, listen. Get a youth.
Everyone, my name is Ian Beer. I was born in Belize City at the old hospital in 1986. I have two lovely kids, a boy and a girl. I live on Sunway Avenue in Belize City. I've been working in Chaka for 10 years and 9 months, to be exact, starting the 1st of August 2006. What I like about working here, I get to interact with a lot of people, have fun with a lovely team. We have enough safety going on here. That's what I love about it. We keep our number one standards at high. We play a lot. It's time to play. That's the logo. I'd like to thank everyone, all my co-workers, managers, supervisor, and thank the good Lord above for still being here of what I am doing today at this moment. Thank you.
Hey. Think it's a game. Think it's a game. Oh.
Jermaine Foster. I'm from Belize City, the old capital. I was born at the Belize Old Hospital. I've been with the company since July 2007. And what I like about the job is the staff and the experience that I've learned throughout the years. And hopefully I'll learn more throughout these years.
DJ Bravo.
and set free your walls. So can just give me my powers. Powers, AI, turn me into masqueraders.